Hello and good evening all. Today I'm going to flush my water cooling because I've used red dye and it's being a bit clogging up the CPU cooler and the radiator. So today is the day I'm going to explain how to drain, flush and refill your water cooling. So, what do you need to start? First and foremost, shut down your PC, switch your power switch off from your PSU. You need paper tissues, something to fill it back up with, an empty bottle, this connection to let your pump run but not your motherboard, I will explain later, and demineralized water. I protected the motherboard and GPU with some paper towels. I unplugged the motherboard plug, the 24 pin, and I'm going to insert this little connection to ensure my motherboard isn't powering up when I'm doing the flushing. Let's get started. You see the loop has been built like reservoir going through something to show that there's flow to my radiator, here in, out the radiator, in to CPU cooler, back to the top of the reservoir. Here. I'm gonna unscrew the top one here, but I need to protect my motherboard and GPU, and I'm gonna lay down some paper towels for the little bit of leakage that's going to come out. I just did a bit of a dumb move when disconnecting this hose and putting it into the bottle. I spilled a few centiliters of red dye fluid and now it's in the bottom of my case. So I need to clean that out. Luckily, I placed some paper towels. I just removed this one and just clean up a little bit to get it and protected the motherboard. Plus, that's why you unplug your power. Now with the bottle in place, I'm gonna start the pump in little short motions by putting power on the PSU with a little switch in the back. Now we stop because you see the reservoir is empty. And you may not let the pump run dry, because then it's broken. You see, now we have a problem. The problem is, it doesn't drain everything, because some things are higher and lower than everything else. So, we're gonna fill up a little bit with fresh, so it gets full again, so we can do another clean run. Now, for flushing, when you empty the loop and you want to flush it some more so to get cleaner water that's more see-through, you take your big bottle, you take your hose from the top of your reservoir, you put it in below the surface of the distilled water, you make it somewhat airtight with some paper towel, put the other end in the bottle and see what happens. It cleans, but you have to stop before your small bottle is full, of course. So now we are cleaning and flushing. You see that the water is not dark red anymore. And stop. So all the discharge is not that dirty anymore and the other side is clear. Repeat this a few bottles and you will be flushed and you can install your water cooling again. The final time, It's clear. That means it's flushed and it's clean. Now, you can install your water cooling again, fill it back up, bleed it again, and use it. The loop is now running. I'm just gonna let it run for a while so all the air bubbles come to the reservoir. Then I'm gonna top it up to the top and let it bleed again. You see, on the CPU, there's some air bubbles going around. We need to get rid of those first. So let it run for a while till it settles, then top it up. Top it off again. Let it bleed. This little nozzle you can leave open so the air can go out. And just top it off every time until the noise is gone. Here you can see it's bleeding. Just let it go for half an hour, an hour. Okay guys, that was it. That was the video about emptying your water cooling loop, flushing it and refilling it again, and I replaced the reservoir on a better location. I hope this goes smooth at your end, because on my end it was a bit of a disaster. Please do not forget to cover up your motherboard with some paper towels and your video cards, and use that special plug so there isn't electricity on your video cards and your motherboard. If you like this video, please subscribe and leave a like. And next video is going to be how to freshly install Windows on a new PC using USB. Thank you for watching, and till the next time. Bye.